Today, I'm going to show you how to use an ESP32 board like this to achieve room-level presence detection with ESPresense and Home Assistant. And if you're ready, let's go! This is one of the easiest setups out there. For this, you're going to need an ESP32 board, a micro USB cable, and a standard 5-volt power supply. And you can even print a simple case like this, or this, to protect your ESP32 board. The number of boards that you'll need depends on the size of your house. So, for example, in my case, I will only need 4 boards to cover all my house. I plan to use one for my entrance slash kitchen, one for the living room, one for my bedroom, and one for the bathroom. That way, I will be able to accurately detect in which room I left my phone, since apparently I am not able to not lose it every 5 minutes. And not only that, I will be able to use this as an additional device tracker to improve the accuracy for my presence detection. And it allows you to create more contextual automations, since now you will know which person is in every room, so your automations can adjust based on who is present in the room. This will be better with something like a smartwatch or a MiBand that will be with you all the time. To get this working, just go to my website. First, you need to install the Mosquitto Broker add-on in Home Assistant. If you don't know how to do it, I will put the link in the description to one of my videos. With that out of the way, just click on ESPresense Installation, then click here to go to the installation page, and now just connect your micro USB cable to your ESP32 board and connect it to your computer. Then just click on Connect. And here you just need to select your device, in my case it's the COM7, and then click Connect. Once it's connected, just click on Install ESPresense, select Erase Device, and then click on Next. And then install. If the installation doesn't start like you are watching, you might need to press one time the button on the left. And that's it, then click on Next. And now configure your Wi-Fi, and click Connect. Every time that I tried it, it failed. But just click Skip, then click on Log and Console, then click on Back again, and that's it. Then just click Visit Device. Here we will give it a name, then enter your MQTT credentials. If you're using the Mosquitto add-on as I suggested, the server should be Home Assistant, so just enter the IP address and use the username and password of your Home Assistant. Then just leave everything as default, and we are going to disable the status LED. For this, just enter -1 here, and then just click on Save. And now just click on Restart Device. And now go to Home Assistant, here go to Settings, Devices and Services, click on MQTT, click on Devices, and if everything went well, you should now have one ESPresense device. Just click on it. Here we have two important settings to adjust. The first one is the absorption. This is the value to account for the amount of stuff between your rooms. We are going to use this value to calibrate our device. For this, just click on Visit, then add a slash UI at the end, and here go to Fingerprints. And here we need to understand how this works, so you can understand its limitations. To calculate the distance, they are using the RSSI value. That is the signal strength with which ESPresense detects another Bluetooth device. This means the calculation of the distance can be affected if, for example, you put your phone in a box, because the signal strength will be lower. So, with that in mind, we are not trying to get an exact value, only a close approximation. So, what I want you to do is put the device that you want to track 2 meters away of the ESPresense device that you want to calibrate, and adjust the absorption value until the distance is close enough to the real value. Every time that you adjust the absorption value, you need to wait a little bit for the distance to be stable again, and try to repeat this exercise putting the device farther away. And that's it! I know that this is not the most accurate way to calibrate the device, but it's simple enough for anyone to do to get better results out of the ESPresense device. And the other one is the max distance. This is the max distance from the board to detect devices. You might want to adjust this value if you find overlapping between your rooms. And now I'm going to show you how to track your Android phone. For this, first install the Home Assistant app. You can use this button here, and then just open Home Assistant on your phone. Open the sidebar, go to Settings, scroll down and touch Companion app. Here, go to Manage Sensors, and we are going to scroll down to Bluetooth. Here, you need to activate the Bluetooth Low Energy Transmitter. Just activate this, scroll down, and we are going to adjust the Advertise Mode to Balance, and the Transmitter Power to Low. These settings were the one that gave me the best performance without impacting my battery life. And that's it. Now, for the MiBand, you need to activate the discoverability option. If you don't find the option in the Set Life app, you can use the app Notify and Fitness for MiBand and activate it there. And after that, you can safely uninstall the application. In version 3 of ESPresense, they added a more reliable Bluetooth tracking for iOS devices. For this, just go to Home Assistant, and here, go to Settings, click on Devices and Services, MQTT, click on Devices, select the ESPresense device more close to your iPhone, and then click on Visit. Here, we just need to add at the end, /UI, and then just give it a name, and click and roll. And now just need to go to your iPhone, look for Bluetooth devices, find ESPresense device, and tap once to connect. It will disconnect itself automatically. So if you see disconnected, everything is okay. And after that, ESPresense will be able to accurately track your iPhone. And now we need to create a sensor in Home Assistant for each device that we want to track. For this, just go to Settings, Devices and Services, click on MQTT, click on Devices, and here we are going to click on the closest ESPresense device that we have. Then click on Visit. Here, just add UI at the end. Then click on Fingerprints. And here we need to find the ID of the device that we want to track. And just copy it, and then go to Home Assistant, click on File Editor, and here under Sensor, we are going to paste the value. Now, go back to my website, and here we are going to copy the value for Create ESPresense Sensor, and just paste it. Since I already have Sensor, I'm going to erase this, and then just update the ID on the template, paste it in Device ID, and at the end of State Topic. Here, just update the name and the wait timeout. This is the amount of time in seconds that ESPresense will wait before setting the device as away. And then just click on Save. Now go to Developer Tools and restart Home Assistant. After it's finished, just click on States. And here we're going to look for the name of the device. And that's it. You can see now that Home Assistant already knows that the device is near the ESPresense entrance device. And now I'm going to show you how to use this with a device tracker. One of the limitations that we have is that this is only a sensor, not a device tracker. So we cannot directly assign it to a person to track it in our house. So for that, I'm going to show you how to create a device tracker. For this, just go to my website, and here, just copy the code for Simulate Device Tracker. Now, go back to Home Assistant, and go to File Editor. Here, we need to paste the code on our known device's YAML file. For this, just click here, and if it doesn't exist, just click on here, and create knownDevices.yaml, and click OK. Now just click on it, and paste the code. Here, you just need to update the ID, and the name of your device. Then just click on Save. And then just go to Developer Tools, and restart Home Assistant. After it's finished, just click on States, and here we are going to filter device tracker. And here it is. Now we need to create an automation. For this, just click on Settings, click on Automations, click on Create Automation, and create new automation. Then go back to my website, and here we are going to copy automation to translate ESPresense sensors to device tracker. Just click on it, and then go back to Home Assistant, click on the three dots here, click on Edit in YAML, just select everything and paste it. Now you need to update the ID of the tracker that you want to update here, and in location name, you need to update the names of your ESPresense devices. And then just click on Save, give it a name, and click Rename. Now click on the three dots again, and click on Edit in Visual Editor. What I wanted to show you is why the template condition is needed. Since this is a Bluetooth device and the distance is updated constantly, if we don't set this condition, every time the distance updates, the automation will execute. Since we want to test this for the first time, click on the three dots and click on Disable. Then click on Save. And we are going to wait for it to be triggered. And then we are going to activate it again. And click on Save again. Now, if you go to Developer Tools, and look for device tracker 1 plus 7, You can see that now I have a device tracker, and I can go to Settings, People, select my user, and add it as a device tracker. And then click Update. This way, all my automations used in person will benefit with this device tracker. I have been doing some testing to verify the accuracy of this. I tested 2 Android phones, 1 iPhone, 1 smartwatch, and 1 MiBand. And I found that unless you're using a MiBand, we are going to get a lot of false negatives, which means that even though the device is home, it's not going to be detected by its Bluetooth. And this is because of the way that mobile devices are built to preserve battery life. What this means is that if you're not using your phone or your smartwatch and it enters deep sleep mode, it will stop advertising its Bluetooth signal. And because of that, ESPresense will not be able to detect that it is home. So, to get around this limitation, if you are not only tracking MiBands, we can modify the automation to get all the benefits without its drawbacks. For this, we are going to erase 2 lines, the line 8 and 9, and then click Save. What this is going to do is that when the device is not home, like this, instead of setting the device tracker to away, it will set it to unknown. This is going to tell Home Assistant to ignore the device tracker. That way, if we get a false negative, instead of setting the person to away, it will just ignore the Bluetooth Low Energy device tracker, and it will use another device tracker to determine if we are home or not. This way, we get all the benefits without being affected with the false negatives. And that's it! If you want to know more, check out my Level Up Your Presence Detection in Home Assistant video. And if you like my work, please consider supporting me on Ko-fi using the button on my website or the link in the description. Either way, I will be eternally thankful. And don't forget to subscribe for more content like this. I'll see you on the next video. Bye!